Okay.
Is that meow?
AJ's like, is that meow?
I'll accept it.
He says he'll accept it.
She's nice. Like,
your name's Meow now. Hey everybody, it's Pembroke W. Corgi, and I'm here with
Mew Bunny.
And we're playing Creepy Castle. My daughter is also in the background, so you might hear her say a few things.
Yeah, boy!
So. On the horizon, a castle-like shadow becomes stone. From the walls seep tales of dark conspiracy within, and to investigate comes the vagrant swordsman, Moth. Coming all this way, had been an endeavor in its own, even to the soul of Wanderlust, but the real trial was only the beginning, and though he is no stranger to happening upon the shady machinations of conspiracy, little could be ever be expected in the immense gravity of what will transpire in this creepy castle.
Whew! It doesn't look all that creepy from the outside, I mean, really.
See, just to further imitate the Spectra ZX, this game purposely has no transparencies. Basic training. Action command. You can always use the next and previous item buttons to highlight your action command. Depending on the context, this could be used as an attack, open chest, save, and more.
Okay, let's hand more. Don't leave me hanging, sign!
And now we got a key. Yeah, that thing that looks like an F is a key. With the next and previous buttons, you can highlight any item to use just like the action command. Keys open doors, food stuff heal HP, and etc. For the longest time, I actually thought etc. was spelled ECT, like the abbreviation. I thought that was the actual spelling of it. Since I never
saw
it.
Can't blame me for that, because nobody ever wants to spell out the entire word.
Well, I never saw it written out for the longest time. And no, for as far as I know, you can't jump or fly as Moth. See, sometimes to get to where you need to go, you'll have to jump off a ledge. Go ahead, it's fine.
I'm not sure I want to.
Splat. You know, any other game, that would be, like, the worst thing. Oh, yeah, here we get the music. Well, I mean, you saw what his wings look like in that picture. I mean, of course he can't fly. They look damaged.
Well, he is a moth. He probably got them wet at some point.
Oh, there you go. That's probably the case.
Or somebody decided to, you know, take some of the dust off of him, so, you know.
Locke. Hey there, I'm Locke. Oh, hey, I haven't seen you since Final Fantasy VI. You've changed a lot. Anyways.
This is what he was doing before Final Fantasy VI.
Oh. He started at the Spectra CX. I'm looking for a certain key. I can tell you about the different kinds of keys. Golden keys like this one are used to open normal doors. Poof. Well, what about other keys? What about the other keys?
Yeah, what about the key of E and B? I mean, this is obviously the F key.
And what about key lime?
What about key Largo?
What about key frame? Monsoon's log, new places. I was right to come here for who knows how long. I have wasted my time stumbling through the night in hunt of shadow, but no more. I shall remain right here at the crossroads of fate, poised to strike. Something big is brewing here, and I intend to stir the pot. Well, that's good, because that's how chocolate's made, I think. For years, I have subsisted on rage alone, often with nary a trace of my mark. Yet, in the mere days since my arrival, multiple potential leads have presented themselves to me. All I have to do now is pace myself. I shall work towards my... my new master's ambition, but I must never forget why I am really here. Master's ambition? Warden, you didn't tell me you're in this game?
Yeah, I thought he was working for Pace Picante Sauce.
Man. Stuff you just don't know about your friends.
Well, he does call himself the master. I mean, he's got to get that reputation somewhere.
Here, I thought it was just a Doctor Who reference.
I know, right? I just like how these eyeballs, you know, just stand there waiting for you to attack them.
Let's see. Food operator's manual. A long day's work will often leave the body weary. Thankfully, when we lose our stamina, there is a solution to exhaustion, the consumption of food. Different foods will restore stamina to varying degrees. The extent of the foodstuff's respiratory capabilities is conveyed at the top of the screen to the right of your level. When a foodstuff is selected, to consume all foodstuff, press your action button when the appropriate foodstuff is selected. Place the food in your mouth and begin the mastication process. Using your mandible function, teeth and tongue to exert force and crush your food. Hey, I've done mastication a lot and I have never once had to use my teeth and tongue for it.
Never once had to use my tongue.
When the food is well ground and sufficiently lubricated with saliva, commencing swallowing by relaxing your throat muscles, opening up your sphincter, and moving the chewed food to the back of your mouth with your tongue. The food will then slide into the esophagus. Automated digestion will follow and nourish your body through absorption of nutrients.
You know, this is an awful long operator's manual.
Between and after swallowing of foodstuff fragments, be sure to resume breathing. See Chapter 1. Have a nice day.
Wait, where's Chapter 1? I need to know how to breathe!
Oh no! Lordy Lou, now what will we do? We'll suffocate! Quick draw. Sometimes when fighting an enemy, a duel will be initiated. They come in quite a few flavors. Quick draw is one such flavor. Wait for the prompt, then hit the confirm button to strike first. But don't be too angsty, or don't be too antsy. Nobody uses that word anymore. Except for, like, my mom. Anyways, and hit the button before the prompt, or you'll fumble and leave yourself wide open. Don't be too hasty. Yeah, this is delicious! Okay. But also, don't be too slow, or you'll just be the punch in the face. Most of the time, you'll just punch each other in the face. Wow.
That's awfully nice to know.
That time Sam punched himself in the face and died in the marsh.
Did you hear what my daughter said?
Yes.
Remember that time Sam punched himself so hard he died in the marsh and Frodo was dead and Pippin just got lost? Joel gives the best version of Lord of the Rings ever.
That's the only version of Lord of the Rings.
I want to see the movie like that. It would be significantly shorter.
No, we'd be sitting there for about half an hour while Frodo it just hogs the bong.
There we go. Alright. Try your best, BF. Yes, it is. And yes, Butterfly does have, she's actually wearing boxing gloves. Supposedly she's a boxer. I just know that from something I accidentally stumbled upon recently when I was looking for artwork.
That's a clever.
Oh?
float like a butterfly, sting like a bee.
Oh, dude, I didn't even think about that. My daughter caught on to that before I did. The fact that butterflies are boxers because, you know, sting like a... float like a butterfly, sting like a bee.
Mm-hmm.
God damn it. I didn't even think of Muhammad Ali for that, despite us talking about the adventures of Muhammad Ali so much. Which somehow survived my fucking format of my hard drive. Because Muhammad Ali is the greatest. Alright. Perfect. Yeah, it took you down. Cross gave me a level up. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for leveling me up, Jesus. I'm sure I was worth it.
Are you sure it's Jesus, not Jesus?
One of them. Oh, I didn't perfect that one. Actually take some damage. See. Struggle. Sometimes you will have to struggle to get away from endure an attack. I see, and Kyo isn't here for this. Is all I have to say. Just press left and right alt buttons alternatively as fast as you can. If you're too slow, there will be painful consequences. Even if you take damage, don't stop struggling, or else you will take even more damage. Try your best, Butterfly. I like Butterfly's design. She's kind of cute looking, too.
Butterfly could kick your ass.
Of course Butterfly could kick my ass. A group of Girl Scouts could kick my ass, dear. It's like they're going to kick my ass. Granted, I don't think we're going to have a fight as long as they, like, don't get rid of the tag-alongs. That's, like, my favorite.
Like tomorrow morning, breaking news,
tag-along's
discontinued.
I'll be like, no! Curse you!
No! They also discontinued Dead Men's! How dare they!
Oh, damn it! I didn't mean to eat that! Ah, damn it. Not paying attention. Oh well. I ate a kumquat.
Before quats come.
I used to call people kumquat as a insult.
Kumquat, kumquat, kumquat!
I used to call people kumquats. Like, you goddamn kumquat. It was mainly because I heard the word but didn't know what it was for the longest time. Let's see. Nittany wants to know if you think he's pretty.
Nittany is the most beautiful boy in the world.
Did you hear that, Nittany? Anyways, fire beauty. What is a fire? A pyre of ire. Beauty which should be desired. I think that to which you should aspire. Is that your soul? Glow like a fire. Meanie Bell, did you write this? How'd you get in this game? Oh, dude. Nittany's response.
Yee!
Actually, it's funny that I said, I made the comment, poetic tendons. Diary. Yeah, you're gonna read about certain. We're gonna read about like certain people that lived in this castle before we came here, and that's the poets. But no, it's funny that I made the comments like Beanie Bell. Did you write this? Because recently, on like Derpy Burrow, they're like posting the crossover that's happening between Arrow and Beanie Bell right now, and someone was like, "Poor Beanie Bell," and then like someone's like, "Oh, she's just gonna use it to." To like use it as inspiration for her next emo poetry session or something, which, you know, obviously means they don't know shit about my character. So I just actually replied to it. It's like, Meebel would be writing poetry, emo or otherwise, because as soon as she'd try to start one, she'd like get one line in and be like, "What rhymes with fire?"
Roses are black, violets are black. I burned everything. There's nothing but destruction around me.
There you go. So, work.
Every, One flower is black, another flower is black. I've burnt down your house, so it's black as well.
That's the thing that Arrow has the benefit of, is Meanie still likes him. She still thinks he's too adorable for, like, I think anybody to really do much mean to him is the problem. It's like,
Arrow looks like Aaron Hansen.
Arrow's like going to be is being a total asshole, but you can't be mad at him because he's not even remotely aware that he's doing anything wrong. See, but anyway.
Now that your daughter mentions it, that hairstyle does remind me of Aaron.
I didn't want to say that. I was trying to ignore that.
The thought hadn't occurred to me just till just now.
Yeah, Aubrey's been kidding. AJ's been kidding about that. She told me that I should tell Desi that that Arrow's Aaron Hansen motherfucking like pony, and I was like, I'm not gonna tell her that. But anyways, fire work ethic, work all day and night to master Darking's delight, burn full of pride. Is that a haiku?
I don't know, but it definitely sounds like something Meanie would say.
Yeah. Light fans, what the fuck is this shit? Okay. firepower. It crackles, it burns, it licks at the air. Fire, 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 fire! The forest despair. Wait, now if I'm gonna do that, I'm gonna do it right. Fire! 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 I haven't watched Beavis and Butthead so long, I can't even, like, remotely try to imitate them.
I didn't even try to watch them when they brought it back.
I watched one, and it was weird. It was kind of like, I was like, yeah, this is the thing I used to watch. And I used to enjoy.
What I wish they'd bring back is Daria.
Yeah, but Mike Judge didn't have much to do with that one other than creating the character.
Pretty much, but still.
And it still wasn't near as popular as Beavis and Butthead was. But I was trying to watch it, and I was just like, by all logic, I should be enjoying this, but really not. I'm just like, I don't know what happened. Because it's like all my other friends that grew up with, I was like, yeah, it's awesome, it's back. And I was just like, I don't know.
Yeah, when I heard it came back, it's like, okay. So they're going to sit there and make fun of music videos again.
Well, no, since that was the funniest thing on it, was the fact that since MTV doesn't really do music videos much anymore, it had them like watching Jersey Shore and making fun of that. And I have to admit, that was actually kind of fucking awesome. But,
okay, I didn't know that part. No one told me that part, but that does sound funny.
Yeah, that was like the closest to the best part, I guess. The actual episode, I was just kind of like, the whole time. I was kind of like, the whole time, I was like, I'd rather just make more King of the Hill episodes. I'll tell you what.
I cringe at King of the Hill every time I watch it.
Because it's too real? If anything, you have to give that show credit. It's the most realistic interpretation of, like, freaking Texas on, like, television.
The sad part is, I'm pretty sure I'd be very much like Dale if I had the money.
you think that's a joke, but it's true, because, like, everything else, like, always paints us as having all these cowboys, and we're like a desert and shit like that, and it's, like, not even remotely close. Or the accents are just super exaggerated.
Mm-hmm.
But, like, King of the Hill, that's fucking Texas, pretty much. It's not even that exaggerated. My favorite part was the episode where Hank was going to have a barbecue, and, like, a few drops of snow appeared, and then everybody just fucking panicked, and Rex tried to get out of the fucking the parking lot.
Accurate.
I was like, yep, that's Texas. That is really fucking accurate. Any snow comes out here, everybody forgets how to fucking drive.
I handled it pretty well the other day, so I can't say anything.
I can handle it well, too. It's just, like, everybody else is the problem.
Mm-hmm. Well, it was like, you know, it was Minnie Sleet, you know, when I first went out, and then while I was still out and I was about to come back home, it was switched to snow flurries. I was like, okay, I prefer snow flurries to the sleet.
You could argue that I'm technically not a Texan, though.
Yeah, you're from dirty Oklahoma.
I'm technically an Okie, because I was born and raised in Oklahoma. It was just as soon as, like, As soon as I graduated from high school, I'm like, I'm out of here, and moved to Texas. As for what it's like to be an Oklahoman, I'll describe it like I said to like Warden and Desi like the other day. It's like being an Oklahoman is like being a Texan, just stupider. Let's see. It's not really. I don't have a problem with tornadoes. Living in Oklahoma, tornadoes don't even fucking bother me. It's like, oh, okay, I'm gonna go into like the fucking closet, or I'm gonna go into the closet now. And then I got out of the closet and I found something new about myself. I mean, it's just like, oh, I'm sitting in the bathtub, okie dokie. Not much else I can do. The problem I have with Oklahoma is there's really like jack shit to do there. I mean, in comparison to like Texas, even like small towns in Texas seem to have more shit to do than like big cities in Oklahoma. Oklahoma's just really fucking boring is the problem.
Mm-hmm.
The town I grew up in, Ardmore, is getting slowly better. It's like they've surprisingly gotten a lot of new places, but even places I like are closing fast because seemingly there's just not people interested in that in Oklahoma. It's like there was like this secondhand sports store that sold secondhand video games really fucking cheap, and it was like every time I went to visit my parents, I'd go there because I could get a whole bunch of old like Nintendo games, Genesis games, like super fucking cheap. And last time I went there, they got closed down, and it made me really sad, because it was like, which I guess I should have expected it, because the time before last, like, not the last time, but the last time I actually got to go to that store, they no longer had Genesis games, and I asked why, and they told me I was the only one buying Genesis games, and I didn't live there. So I was like,
no, you take Oklahoma's for it. You should try hanging out in Nebraska sometime.
Oh God, I've never even been to Nebraska.
I used to have yearly family reunions in Nebraska. Oh. And of course, the place we stayed was with family out in farmland.
See, that reminds me, is Vinny in the chat? I can make a comment about the one time I went to Mississippi. No, he's not. Mississippi, like, I went to Mississippi once, and Mississippi had, like, the grossest, like, water I've ever showered in. Like, I swear, it was, like, nasty. It was, like, really gross. It was, like, I felt like I was showering in, like, after I showered, I felt like there was a whole film around me. Like, after I showered, it was like the water was just really strange.
It's weird to say it had him on.
Do you mind?
I have no problem with it.
Alright. I'll add you in, Warden.
It's your stream, dude.
I'm going to have to make a new icon. A new, like, logo. Well, I have to make all new logos anyways. I lost all the logos that I had for everybody in the when I posted them on YouTube. Because you could kind of see that in the Tattletale one. I didn't use the logo. I just found the Sega font again and just typed it out because...
Yeah.
I'd lost it.
He's Warren, who's a prisoner?
We're all prisoners of Warren, dear. Warren owns us all.
Yeah, we're all on that tiny island in the middle of nowhere that we can't escape. We can't escape that... We can't... that prison because, you know, there's a strange bubble that comes and tries to kill us every time we try to escape.
I'm trying to call you, Warden. Are you there?
No. I ran away.
Oh, great.
Oh, okay.
Now we have a stream with three Texans. Well, two Texans and an Oklahoman. And an Okie.
Okay. So, let's go ahead and do this. It's not Nebraska, it's cornfield.
See, yeah. Well, for when this comes on YouTube, introduce yourself, Warden, even though I already said you're being added to it.
Well, for the YouTubers who actually care, I'm Warden. I don't do much.
He helps write a comic about a pony that cross-dresses.
And
he's breaking my pony's heart as we speak.
Yeah. Anyway, so yeah, there is a thing that I wanted to poke you about, because I hadn't... There is a thing that I want to get into, but I don't know how to get into it. And maybe you know how to get into it.
Okay, can I read the sign real quick just to get out of
it? I'm an old gray muzzle fur fag.
See, talking... Because I need to get back to playing the game, too. So when I get past that, we can start talking. Talking. People can converse... How ironic. People can converse with a speech bubble above their head. Many have multiple messages. When you have exhausted the conversation, the speech bubble disappears.
Okay. That's not ironic. I don't see a speech bubble here.
This is not ironic. This is coincidental.
Yeah, I know. I actually have corrected people on that a lot, too. Because the actual use of irony is when you use a word for something opposite of its actual meaning.
When a situation occurs completely opposite how you thought it would go, and it's completely hilarious. That's irony!
Yeah. See, they had a whole episode about on Futurama about that. That was like a side gag throughout the whole thing.
Well, irony. This is irony, okay? A man walks underneath an open ladder, knocking it over. You would think that the can of paint sitting on top of the ladder is going to fall and hit the man on the head. No. Instead, it falls, does nothing, and the man steps into an open manhole cover. That's irony.
Yeah. All right. Snack. Have you come to investigate what's going on around here? It's getting dangerous. I'm going to escape. You would be wise to do the same. Good thing I can use the map by pressing the pause button and take a look where I've been. Oh, hey, that's helpful. Look at that. We got a map.
We did it!
Okay. Oh, well. Anyway,
with that being said, so here's the thing. I kind of want to get into Gmod.
I don't know anything about Gmod.
There are people who do.
I know a lot of people like use those Gmod pony things, and they look really creepy, and I don't like how they look. They always just look unsettling to me for some reason. I don't know what it is. I think it's because their eyes look so dead.
Plastic toys?
Yeah, it's like... Yeah, that's pretty much it. It looks like somebody's animating one of my My Little Pony toys instead of having a 3D My Little Pony.
I know, right? It's hilarious.
Yeah, I was trying to get Nerfy Science to make me one, but you could never find the right stuff for it, and then just got out of the... Kind of got depressed on hood stuff, so I just left him alone about it.
The only reason I even bring this up is because there's a specific map that lets you chase down a Category 5 tornado.
Oh.
And it's kind of funny getting caught up in one of these things.
Let's see.
And watching it tear through the map.
Oh, you've got Nitty's interest. Oh, hey, Trapathusiast Magazine. All right, there better be pictures of Bridget and Chiron in this. I'm 100%. Oh, wait a minute. Falling down, carpentry, headache, or literal headache. Falling ceilings. You may feel alarmed when your stronghold falls with this repair, but don't. Let that decrepit roof be a threat to your intruders. Only those with quick feet will get away in time, and only perceptive protags will notice the visual difference on this dilapidated ceiling. See you next month with a specialty trap sure to knock you off your feet. It's a real ball. Stay crafty, trappers.
So it was written by Fred Jones?
Yeah, Freddie Jones. I'm disappointed. There wasn't a picture of like She-Ron or Bridget in this at all. I'm really disappointed.
I don't even know who that is.
Females. Okay. Sleepy Tenant's Diary. I'm the first to move into the new living accommodations. I have a pretty cozy little joint. I love it. I was a little nervous when people were getting moved out to make room so scientists could sleep closer to their work, but this might be all right. The lead of the IUS development moved in next door. He's nice, but I guess he doesn't need to sleep at night because he's made of plasma, as he says, so he's kind of noisy. I asked him to keep it down, but I still hear his poetry reading. I can't believe it. This hack thinks he's Bugsphere. Every time I ask him to watch the volume or at least the meter, he's back at it. Again, in half an hour. And since he's, can't use paper, he's always loudly chisels his poems into tablets. At least I hope it's just tablets. It can't be the wall, right? I fear he's doing terrible things to the structure of both stone and stanza alike. Because that's the guy we read about, the diary of earlier.
That's Tony's. What's Tony got to do with any of this? I don't understand.
He's the boss.